हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू क्लास 9 इंग्लिश ई लर्निंग। विल स्टार्ट अवर नेक्स्ट लेसन। द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज द लॉस्ट चाइल्ड। इट इज रिटन बाय मुल्क राज आनंद। मुल्क राज आनंद वॉज एन इंडियन राइटर। ही हैज रिटन मैनी नॉवेल्स एंड शॉर्ट स्टोरीज। ही वॉज कन्फर्ड विद साहित्य अकेडमी अवार्ड फॉर इंग्लिश लिटरेचर and he has also received Padam Bhushan Award. In this chapter, a child goes to a fair with his parents. He is happy and excited and wants the sweets and toys displayed there. But his parents don't buy them for him. Why then does he refuse when someone else offers them to him? In this chapter, when the child is, he goes to a fair with his parents, then he wants many things, but his parents deny that time. And afterwards, some other person is giving all these things. Why he denies, that is mentioned in the chapter. So, we'll begin our chapter. It was the festival of spring. From the wintry shades of narrow lanes and alleys emerged a gaily clad humanity. It was a festival for the people here. And the spring season means after the winter season, when February, March month comes, that time the people are interested or they feel good to come out of the winter season. And in that wintry shades, in the narrow lanes, people were moving, coming out. In the Elysee Street, they were coming out, they were very happy and well dressed. Some walked, some rode on horses. Some people were coming by walking and some were coming on the horses. Others sat being carried in bamboo and bullock carts. Some were sitting on the bamboo and some were coming in bullock carts. One little boy ran between his father's legs, brimming over with life and laughter. There was a boy in the fair who was happy. He was full of energy and happiness. He was playing between his father's legs. "Come, child, come," called his parents as he lagged behind, fascinated by the toys in the shops that lined the way. The child was called by his parents as the child was lagging behind. As the parents were moving ahead and the child was looking back at the toys, he was attracted by the toys which were hanging in the shop or they were lined in the on the way on in the shops. He hurried towards his parents, his feet obedient to call their call. He hurried towards his parents. He was trying to move. He was very fast moving towards his parents as his parents' feet were obedient. Means he was listening to his parents and going ahead, but his eyes still lingering on the receding toys. But eyes were more focused towards the toys which were lagging behind. As he came to where they had stopped to wait for him, he could not suppress the desire of his heart, even though he well knew the old cold stare of refusal in their eyes. When he moved ahead, he tried to suppress, but he could not suppress his desire, means he could not control it. He was willing to purchase and he asked, and he was knowing that he will be refused. Whatever he is asking to his parents, they will refuse. Then also he asked, "I want that toy," he pleaded. Pleaded is requested. The child requested his parents that he wants a toy. His father looked at him red-eyed in his familiar tyrant's way. His father looked at him with angry red eyes. His father looked at him. His mother melted by the spirit, free spirit of the day. And mother understood. And she was melted, means her heart was very soft and she understood, but she tried to attract her child towards other ways so that he will not ask. Giving him her finger to hold said, then mother said, "Look, child, what is before you?" She wanted to distract the child from that thing to other thing. It was flowering mustard field, pale light melting gold as it swept across miles and miles of even land. When he was moving, he just looked. he saw flowering mustard field and was looking pale, means light yellow color, melting gold, as if gold. This mustard field was looking yellow, just like melting gold, and whole miles and miles it was covered with mustard. A group of dragonflies were bustling about on their gaudy purple wings. Intercepting the flight of a lone black bee or butterfly in search of sweetness from the flowers. There were a group of dragonflies. They were coming, they were moving with full energy, and they were having bright purple wings, and they were intercepting the flight of the black bee. Black bee and the butterfly, they were moving in that field. They were crossing from one place to other, and these dragonflies were trying to intercept them from that way they were crossing each other. The child followed them in the air with his gaze, till one of them would still its wings and rest, and he would try to catch it. And child followed them, the child followed to catch this butterfly, and his concentration was towards that, and he tried to hold it, but it would go fluttering, flapping up into the air when he had almost caught in his hands. Anyhow, he has tried to catch a butterfly, but it would go, because then when he tried to catch it, then same time the mother called him. Then mother gave a cautionary call, come child, come on to the footpath. When he has tried to catch that butterfly, that time mother called him, come child, come, and she called the boy. He ran towards his parents gaily and walked abreast of them for a while, being however soon left behind, attracted by the little insects and worms along the footpath that were teeming out from their hiding places to enjoy the sunshine. The boy ran towards his parents. He was running towards his parents. He was very happy, and he walked by abreast, means side by side. He moved side by side his parents, and he was trying to see. He was attracted again by little insects and worms, and these insects and worms were coming on the way on the footpath, and they were coming out, and they were teeming out from their hiding place. Actually, insects used to live under the ground in the holes, and when for the sun, these to get the sunlight, these insects come up, and these insects and worms were coming out of their hiding places. And then child saw these insects. Come child, come, his parents called from the shade of a grove where they had seated themselves on the edge of a well. And when he was willing to see these insects and worms, again parents called, come child, come, and parents were sitting on the edge of a well nearby a grove. And grove is a small garden, you can see. He ran towards them. A shower of young flowers fell upon the child as he entered the grove, and forgetting his parents, he began to gather the raining petals in his hands. When parents called him, he ran towards them. And again, when he was walking from the place that when he entered the grove in that garden, some flowers, means young flowers, fell upon the child. And he began to gather the raining petals. The petals of the flowers, they were falling, and he tried to collect these petals in his hands. But lo, he heard the cooing of doves. And same time he heard the cooing of doves, sound of the bird, doves, and ran towards his parents, shouting, the dove, the dove. The raining petals dropped from his forgotten hands. And when he heard the sound of doves, he moved towards. Again he was called by the parents. Parents tried to show this dove. Parents said, the dove, the dove. And then child again left the raining petals. It was dropped from his hands, and the child moved towards the dove. "Come, child, come," they called to the child, who had now gone running in wild capers round the banyan tree, and gathering him up, they took the narrow, winding footpath which led to the fair through the mustard fields. Again parents called the child. They called him who was running near the banyan tree in the wild capers. Wild capers is prickly shrub. He was round, playing round the banyan tree, and taking him, his parents took the boy and they went towards the village fair, and through the winding path, footpath of which went through the mustard field. That means from the middle of the mustard field there was a winding path. From that place parents went along with the child. As they neared the village, the child could see many other footpaths full of throngs converging to the whirlpool of the fair, and felt at once repelled and fascinated by the confusion of the world he was entering. As the child neared the village, means when he was approaching the village, he saw footpath full of throngs, means he saw a large crowd, means everybody was going from that village to that fair, and converging to the whirlpool of the fair, means there was at the center, nearby that fair, everybody was gathered, and he was repelled. You say if he was afraid, he was scared of that mob, that crowd, and he was confused whether he should go or not, and fascinated by the confusion of the world he was entering. But later on, he was attracted by the mob, and then he decided to go. A sweetmeat seller hawked gulab jamun, rasgulla, barfi, jalebi at the corner of the entrance, and a crowd pressed round his counter at the foot of an architecture of many coloured sweets decorated with leaves of silver and gold. There was a sweetmeat seller. He was calling, you can say he was just announcing that whatever he was selling, gulab jamun, rasgulla, barfi, and crowd pressed round his counter, means there was a crowd nearby his shop. Everybody was willing to purchase these sweets, and these sweets were well decorated in the shops, and these were decorated in different colors, leaves of silver and gold, means looking beautiful, silver and gold, means the sweets were decorated in that color. The child stared open-eyed, and his mouth watered for the barfi that was his favorite sweet. And the child, he gazed at these sweets. He was willing to get some sweets, and especially he liked the barfi, and his mouth watered. Then he asked, "I want that barfi," he slowly murmured. But he half knew as he begged that his plea would not be heeded, because his parents would say he was greedy. So without waiting for an answer, he moved on. Slowly he just whispered, "I want that barfi." But he was knowing that whatever request he is doing, that will not be granted, and parents will not pay attention to him. That's why he left that place, and without waiting that parents will give answer or they will purchase, they moved. Means the child moved from that place. A flower shelled hawk, a garland of gulmohar, the child seemed irresistibly drawn. He went toward the basket where the flowers lay heaped and half murmured, "I want that garland." But he well knew his parents would refuse to buy him those flowers, because they would say that they were cheap. So without waiting for an answer, he moved on. Again he listened the sound, he heard the sound of flower seller. He was announcing a garland of flower. He was willing to sell that garland of flower. The child was drawn towards the flower seller. Again, he was knowing that his parents will not listen, they will not give him, and definitely they will give some different reply, means they will refuse it, and they may say that they were cheap, that's why they will not purchase. And without waiting any answer, means without a hope, he moved on. A man stood holding a pole with yellow, red, green and purple balloons flying from it. The child was simply carried away by the rainbow glory of their silken colors, and he was filled with an overwhelming desire to possess them all. But he well knew his parents would never buy him the balloons, because they would say he was too old to play with such toys. So he walked on further. A man was standing. He was holding a pole, and which on that pole different color balloons were flying. Yellow, red, green and purple balloons were flying on that pole. And the child was carried away. Means again the child was attracted by this different color balloons, and was so much overwhelming desire, means he was willing to purchase these balloons. But still he was knowing the answer, that parents would never buy these balloons, as they will say that this is not the age for playing such toys, means according to his age he should not play with the balloon. Then he walked further. A snake charmer stood playing a flute to a snake which coiled itself in a basket, its head raised in a graceful bend like the neck of a swan, while the music stole into its invisible ears like the gentle rippling of an invisible waterfall. Here the child was attracted by the snake charmer. There was a snake charmer in the fair. He was playing a flute, and in the basket there was a snake, and the snake was coiling itself. He was raising its head in a graceful way, just like the neck of a swan. Swan is a bird. And while the music of the flute, the snake was moving its head as if that snake ear is not visible, and it can feel the vibrations of the flute. With that invisible ears, it was raising his head and it was looking beautiful. It was just like an invisible waterfall, the way it was raising his head's movement in the neck, or you can say of the head part of the snake. Means it was coming out of the basket and rippling like a waterfall. The child went towards the snake charmer, and the child moved towards that snake charmer, but knowing his parents had forbidden him to hear such coarse music as the snake charmer played, he proceeded further. Now he was again knowing that his parents do not like, they prohibit him to listen the unpleasant sound, coarse sound, you can say coarse, unpleasant music of the snake charmer, he should not listen. And then he proceeded further. From that place he moved ahead. There was a roundabout in full swing. Men, women and children carried away in a whirling motion, shrieked and cried with dizzy laughter. He saw a roundabout swing, and there on that roundabout men, women and children were sitting there, and they were shrieking, they were making noise, they were enjoying, they were laughing. And then the child watched them intently, carefully. He watched these people who were on the roundabout. And then he made a bold request. Then he thought, he tried to make a bold request. And earlier he was requesting. Now he decided that he will make a bold request. I want to go on the roundabout, please, father, mother. He just said this thing. He want to go on the roundabout. There was no reply. He turned to look at his parents. They were not there ahead of him. He turned to look on either side. They were not there. He looked behind, there was no sign of them. He was willing to go on the roundabout when he asked. He requested his parents. He saw that his parents were not there. He just saw both the sides. Either side he just saw at the back, but there was no sign of the parents. A full deep cry rose within his dry throat, and with a sudden jerk of his body he ran from where he stood, crying in real fear, "Mother, father!" Tears rolled down from his eyes, hot and fierce. His flushed face was convulsed with fear. Panic stricken, he ran to one side first, then to other, hither and thither in all directions, knowing not where to go. "Mother, father!" he wailed. His yellow turban came untied and his clothes became muddy. The child started crying and his neck was dry, and with sudden movements he started crying and he was moving in different directions, continuously crying, and tears were rolling from his face, from his eyes, and his face was hot and he was afraid also. His flushed face was convulsed with fear. He was afraid of the people and afraid of that he will lose his parents. He was panicked. He was moving here and there and only shouting and wailing and crying, "Mother, father!" And that time his turban was also untied and clothes became muddy. Having run to and fro in a rage of running for a while, he stood defeated, his cries suppressed into sobs. At little distances on the green grass, he could see through his filmy eyes men and women talking. He tried to look intently among the patches of bright yellow cloths, but there was no sign of his father and mother among these people who seemed to laugh and talk just for the sake of laughing and talking. He ran here and there. He was in a rage of running. He was in anger, violent stress, anger. He was moving in different directions and then he was crying also. He was defeated by his crying. His cries were suppressed into sobs, and then he was trying to search his parents among this group of men and women. The men and women were talking each other, and he used tried to search his parents, look for his parents. He was looking carefully among that group. Maybe he will get his father and mother. He ran quickly again, this time to a shrine to which people seemed to be crowding. He ran towards a shrine. A shrine is a sacred place. You can say a tomb or you can say a temple. Every little inch of space here was congested with men, but he ran through people's leg, his little sob lingering, "Mother, father!" Near the entrance of the temple, however, the crowd became very thick. Men jostled each other, heavy men with flashing murderous eyes and hefty shoulders. In the temple, what he noticed? That there was no space and it was filled with men. And that place was full of crowd, means people were there, men were there. And he tried to make a space, he ran through the people's leg. And his little sob lingering, he was still sobbing and he was calling, "Mother, father!" trying to search his mother, father in that crowd. And near the entrance of the temple, the crowd became very thick. Just entrance, it was very crowded, it was thick crowd. And men were, people were pushing each other, the heavy men were there with flashing, and there were people who were strong, men were very strong with flashing murderous eyes, that they will, when they were pushing each other, they were, some people were there angry and they will murder each other. That means their angry eyes, you can say murderous eyes, and their hefty shoulders means their strong shoulders, heavy shoulders, they can even fight with each other.
The poor child struggled to thrust away between their feet, but knocked to and fro by their brutal movement. The child tried to get a place or thrust to push them to get away from that from the legs or between the crowd, and he was knocked to and fro. Some means infant or getting again back to and fro motion by their brutal movements, cruel movements of the people. Means that the child was in the mob, in the crowd, and he was trying to move ahead. He was knocked by the legs of the men. He might have been trampled underfoot had he not shrieked at the highest pitch of his voice, "Father, mother!" And that time there was chances of that he would be crushed by, trampled by the foot of the people. But still he was shrieking at the highest voice, "Father and mother!" And man in his surging crowd heard his cry, and stooping with great difficulty lifted him up in his arm. And in that crowd there was man. He was in that moving crowd. Surging means moving crowd. A man heard his cry, and then he bent to see. He saw that boy with great difficulty. He lifted the boy in his arms.
"How did you get here, child? Whose baby are you?" the man asked as he steered clear of the mass. The child wept more bitterly than ever now, and only cried, "I want my mother, I want my father." And when the child was moved from that place, means the person who has lifted the boy, he asked, "Whose baby are you?" Means who, and he wanted to ask where he is, from where he is coming, and who are the parents. And the man tried to ask, but the child was started again bitterly crying, and he just said, "I want my father and mother." The man tried to soothe him by taking him to the roundabout. The man, he tried to console the boy, means he was crying, he wanted to take him on the roundabout. Then he asked, "Will you have a ride on the horse?" If he is interested to go on the, to have a ride on the horse, he gently asked as he approached the train. The child's throat tore into thousand shrill sobs, and he only shouted, "I want my mother, I want my father." But the child, he was not interested to go on roundabout, he was not interested to take a ride on the horse, and he just, his throat was, he was so much tired of crying, and he started sobbing, and he shouted, "I want my mother." He wanted his father and mother only. The man headed towards the place where the snake charmer still played on the flute to the swaying cobra. Man took the boy toward the snake charmer where he was still playing the flute. And then he tried to show that boy that maybe he will be engaged in that listening of the music played by the snake charmer, and he would see the snake. And then he said, "Listen to that nice music," he requested. But the child, he closed his ear, he shut his ears with his fingers, and he shouted with double voice, and he said, he wanted his mother and father. The man took him near the balloons, thinking the bright colors of the balloons would distract the child's attention and quieten him. Again, man tried to give him balloons. He took him towards the balloon seller, and he thought that the child will be distracted. He will accept, his attention will be diverted, means he will not cry, he will be silent, and he will enjoy the balloons. And he asked, "Would you like a rainbow colored balloon?" He persuasively asked, he continuously asked, so that he will take that balloon. The child turned his eyes from the flying balloons and just sobbed, "I want my mother, I want my father." But the child did not accept these balloons, and he was only sobbing. He asked for only mother and father. The man, still trying to make the child happy, bore him to the gate where the flower seller sat. "Look, can you smell those nice flowers, child? Would you like a garland to put around your neck?" The child turned his nose away from the basket and reiterated his sob, "I want my mother and I want my father." Again, when the man tried to make the child happy, he just took him towards the gate where the flower seller was sitting, and he asked him to smell the nice flowers, and he asked him if he wants that garland flowers to put in his neck. The child turned his nose. He was not willing to smell that flowers, and he moved from that place, and again he was sobbing. He asked, "Where is his father?" He wanted his father and mother. Thinking to humor his disconsolate charge by his gift of sweets, the man took him to the counter of the sweet shop. "What sweets would you like, child?" he asked. The child turned his face from the sweet shop and only sobbed, "I want my mother, I want my father." The man thought that maybe these things is not attracting the child and he is sad. He will be happy with the gift of sweets, and he took the boy to the sweet counter. He asked for the sweet, which sweet he is interested to take. Then again the child moved his face, turned his face from the sweet shop, and he sobbed and asked for mother and father. So this is your chapter. Now I think you all must have got it. So the message of this chapter you can get very easily. Every child is willing to get different types of things, especially when the child goes to a fair and the child is attracted by that toys in the birds or the balloons or having a ride on the horse or whatever may be that is available in the shops or the market or in the fair. But compared to that, when the child is asked for the parent, definitely the child loves his parents, though the parents are strict, though the parents deny these things, but still the children most important are the parents, means they love their parents. And compared to all worldly things, materialistic things, parents are more important for every child. Thank you.